get ready to match the stars. Nipsey Russell, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly. From Three's Company, Suzanne Summers. From Family Feud, Richard Dawson. And Patty Lawrence. As we play the star-studded Big Body Match Game, PM.
Hello, Johnny. Oh, how are you? Thank you very much for joining us here. The beautiful people are out, especially for you, and I greet you and ask you to help me greeting our two players here, Harriet Levinson and Jim Yates.
Hello, Jim.
Harriet. Hello there. Now we'll begin by finding out a little bit about each of you, and Jim, if you please, we'll begin with you, sir.
Yes, I'm a landscape contractor. I'm from Philadelphia, the father of three. I enjoy bowling, doing card tricks, and watching game shows.
Really? You have a TV set out in the garden? Is that how you do it?
Sometimes I double in and watch it and double back.
Aha. Well, all right, Jim. Good luck to you, sir. And now you, my dear, where are you from and all that?
Redondo Beach, California.
Redondo Beach, California. Got a lot of friends out there. Bring a rooting section with you, did you?
Yes, I did. A few, yes. I don't work anymore. I left my job in December, and I need to win
either.
A lot of money so I can continue to live, guys.
Oh, okay. All right, good luck to both of you. May I point out that here on Match Game PM, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of them as you possibly can. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner, and will go on to play that big money super match, which can pay off over $10,000. Jim, it's up to you to have A or B.
A
it is for Jim Yates, and it reads as follows. Ned said, my wife is really concerned about the water shortage here in California. Yesterday I came home, and she was taking a shower with the blank man. Came home yesterday, my wife was taking a shower with the blank man.
I hate that.
Come on, Charles.
Well, it's a hard one.
Here we go, Jim. Ned said, my wife is really concerned about the water shortage here in California. Yesterday, I came home. She was taking a shower with the blank man.
The mailman.
The mailman.
Don't be tacky.
Now, wait a minute. What's wrong? That's a reasonable response, isn't it? What would you say? Anarchy is not appreciated in this room. What do you say?
Well, you see, I work nights. And when I came home, it was early in the morning. She was taking a shower with the milkman.
He said mailman. All right.
Okay. What did he say? What'd you say?
Jim Yates said mailman.
Oh, I thought he said milkman.
No, he said mailman.
Oh, you said milkman.
That's where you heard it. What do you say?
I had so many things, I tell you, I couldn't make up my mind. But I finally ended up with milk, because I thought that would be the most obvious.
The milkman. Well, okay.
I said milkman, too.
Three milkmen up there. Well, we may get something different here. I came home yesterday, and she was taking a shower with the mailman. Suzanne, what do you say?
Now, we all know that everybody needs milkman.
Milkman. Well, I suppose the milkman is more prevalent. There are more of those than the... I don't know.
Like half and half. I said the milkman.
You did. Now, it's possible you may get a mailman out of Patty Deutsch.
Not likely.
That doesn't sound nice.
Right.
I said pizza man, he delivers.
Good thinking. Harriet, here we go with Harriet's first rounder. Tiny Tom Thumb said, when I went out west, I was too tiny to bust Broncos, so instead I got a job as a blank buster.
Oh!
I was too tiny to bust Broncos, so instead I got a job as a blank buster. I remember you. You've been here for 2 days.
A couple minutes, anyway.
Now we're ready. Tiny Tom Thumb said, when I went out west, I was too tiny to bust broncos, so instead I got a job as a blank buster.
A burrow buster.
A burrow buster.
Donkeys? Burrows?
Because they would be smaller
than
bronc. Well, I think maybe Tiny Tom, remember, he was only about so big.
I know, but
what'd you say, Nipsey?
Well, I thought about a small burro, or the synonym, therefore, and I put pony buster.
Pony buster. Close to her answer, but not a match.
You wouldn't.
Is that
a
close?
Pony?
Close, but no cigar?
That's right.
I have to take my glasses off. I can't even see with them on anymore. I said pony, too. I'm sorry.
Two ponies. Charles?
I said a mouse buster.
Now, that's getting close to it. Yeah. For Tiny Tom Thumb, that would be it. Isn't that right, Suzanne?
That Charles is very smart.
Yeah, he is indeed. Mouse, all right. Two mice so far.
They're not hard, actually, to train.
They're not. No,
rats are the ones that get in.
Yeah.
Rat buster.
Very difficult.
Yeah.
All right, Miss Patty Deutsch.
This is a little-known vicious animal of the Wild West.
Oh, really?
He was a bunny buster.
A bunny buster. Oh, yeah. Well, that gets you every time. So there we are at the end of round one. As you can see, we have a very tight duel here going. Two great players here. But we'll come up with a winner eventually after we do a little business with America. All right, the score, as we all can plainly see, is tied. Jim went first last time, so Harriet will ask you to go first this time. You have A or B?
B.
B, that's the one over here with the curlicue.
Yes, sir.
Right, okay. From her bed in the Never Never Land Hospital, mm-hmm. Shirley said, I'll never, never blank with Captain Hook again. That's what she said.
Never, never.
Shirley said that from her bed in the Never Never Land Hospital. I'll never, never blank with Captain Hook again.
None of your business. He wants to know what I put in. I'm not showing him.
Okay.
You never show me.
Oh. Don't fight, children. Ready?
Not really, but...
Well, there it is. Harriet. From her bed in the Never Never Land Hospital, Shirley said, I'll never, never blank with Captain Hook again.
Neck.
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 Never, never.
Neck?
Yeah.
It's not a good one?
Good. Yeah, Hello, darling.
Scratches.
What do you say?
Well, when it comes to grabbing and groping, he's a tough man. Neck.
Oh! Well.
Now the real reason why I wouldn't show Charles my answer is about to be revealed.
Why?
I said crochet.
Crochet?
We had that little hook.
Oh, I see. And you crochet with a hook.
What do you expect from a woman wearing a tablecloth? Honestly, Barbara. I said hold hand.
Hold hand. Close to necking, but not quite achieving the thing we're looking for. She's looking for necking. You remember?
Oh, yeah.
When you were in high school?
The old backseat.
Yes.
I think this is very close. Fool around?
Fool around.
What
about
that?
Yeah. In the bed of the Never Never Land Hospital, Shirley said, I'll never, never fool around with Captain Hook again.
The guy said the neck didn't know much about anatomy.
Right.
That's right.
I said make love and play hooky.
Make love and play hooky. Thank you. I mean, it's great to work with creative people, isn't it? Hello there.
Hi.
Oh, now we come to her.
This may be a match.
It could be.
Cut cards.
No, I mean, it's very close, but not really a match.
Yeah.
Okay, are you ready for yours? All right, Jim.
I'm ready.
This is what it says here. Kenny the consumer is never satisfied.
Wants more for his money.
No. Kenny the consumer is never satisfied. He once returned a blank because it had a hole in the middle. Kenny the consumer once returned a blank because it had a hole in the middle. Okay. Okay.
I'm going to spell this.
Well, just
spelling
down here.
Yeah.
Figure out it. That's splendid. Okay. Now we come to you, Jim. Think it over carefully. I'll read it to you one more time. Kenny the consumer is never satisfied. He once returned a blank because it had a hole in the middle.
It has to be donut.
Yeah. Donut. They're with you. The audience loves Jimmy's answer.
Yeah, but you see, I was trying to be clever. I thought bagel, but I wrote down donut.
Oh, you did? That really the same. Bagel is nothing but a varnished donut, isn't it?
Donut dipped in cement.
Yes.
Yeah, it's true. He thought all was lost, right?
Right.
Well, you never can tell. Oh, it I is. Said donut.
Oh, you said it. Now you got two there, Jim. What do you say, Charles?
Donut again.
Ho-ho! Jim Yates is rolling along there, Suzanne. What are you going to contribute?
I was confused over the spelling, but it's donut.
A donut. There it is. I got four. What do you offer, Jim Yates?
I'm going to offer him some gloves for his hands. Going to be punchy at the end of this round.
He's blood plus, like
yeah,
me.
They'll throw you a fish if you do that, Jim. Watch out.
Let me punch
you. Donut.
There it is. Hurts me to hear him applaud.
Yeah.
What
don't
do you...
worry.
He's not going to applaud now, right?
Lifesaver.
Lifesaver. There's one in every crowd, Jim. Don't worry
he's
about
just
it.
He's saving his hands, Gene.
Right. Okay. What ahead? Well, here we go to round three. Round three. All right. Now, Jim, you're ahead, so we're going to ask you to go first. You may have A or B again.
A again.
A again. All right. The bartender said to Harvey... The bartender said to Harvey...
Only one person?
He said, I'll tell you why they call this drink the wall banger. One sip and you want to bang your blank against the wall. You don't play. You don't play.
And I'm glad I don't play.
You don't play. Patty, you're the only one.
That is, yeah.
One sip and you want to bang your blank against the wall. All right, Jim Yates. The bartender said to Harvey, I'll tell you why they call this drink the wall banger. One sip and you want to bang your blank against the wall.
Patty, I trust you. Head.
Head. Head. Good answer. All right, Patty, he said Haid. H-A-I-D. Haid.
Yeah. I'm doing the best I can with what I've got.
Come on.
This is General Head. Shelf.
Wanted to bang himself? Yes or no? No, sorry. That is not a match according to the judge. Now, Harriet, here's what you have to do. You got to match 2 to tie, 3 to win. Okay. Ready?
Okay.
Ready. Ben said, my dentist has a great way to keep your mind off the pain. While he's drilling your tooth, his nurse stands in front of you and blanks. You don't play.
I play.
You play,
and
Chuck plays. That means you matched in the first round, you see. Okay.
But it was on last time.
All right, Chuck is ready. I'll read it while he's finishing up there. Ben said, my dentist has a great way to keep your mind off the pain. While he's drilling your tooth, his nurse stands in front of you and blanks.
Strips.
That's what I had.
Is that what you had?
Yeah.
You play, don't you?
Well, I thought it was closer to... Don't give up the ship, Jim. I said flashes.
Flashes. Now, you must match...
Stripping is boring. Flashing is interesting.
You must match the two remaining ones, Harriet, to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Let's see if that happens. Charles.
I said she strips down with just plain dental floss.
Okay. Score now 5-4. 5-4.
Oh, I've got to go.
Okay. Will you come back a little bit later? It's been splendid having
four,
you here with us.
Come back at 4:30. First time
you've ever done
that. That's right.
Embarrassing.
Excuse me, can I go with you?
Yeah. No, Patty, the thing is, the score is 5-4, and she's got to match you to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Now it's time to show your card. She's looking for the answer strips.
What? Oh. Well, I don't know. I mean, this may be closer to stripping.
She was an English major in school.
Yes.
And,
yes.
Drama.
Flashes a lot.
No. Flashes a lot. Jim Yates wins the game. pleasure to meet you. We thank you very much for being with us here on Match Game PM. Harriet Levinson, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank
while we're spinning her off, let's spin a few commercials just for you. How do you feel? Now it's time for the Big Money Super Match, where Jim Yates here could win over $10,000. Now, to do that, Jim, we're going to have two audience matches for you. And I want to point out, whatever you win in these audience matches, we will multiply by 10. And then that final amount is a dollar figure you'll be playing for. Here we go. We polled the studio audience right in this very hallowed hall not too long ago. And we said, write down your best answer to this. Bucket blank. If you match the answer they gave us most frequently, you get $500. And for matching the second most popular answer, you get $250. And for matching the third, you get $100. And three of the six celebrities are going to hip you.
Richard.
Bucket of chicken.
Bucket of chicken. Okay.
Nipsey.
Bucket.
You know when they have a fire, bucket brigade.
Yeah. Bucket brigade. Okay.
Susan.
Bucket of blood.
Bucket of blood. Okay, those are the three. Bucket of blood, bucket of chicken, and bucket brigade. You may choose one of those. You might have a better idea in your head. Think carefully now and give us your response.
Well, I have to follow orders. My daughter told me to go to Richard. I'm sticking with Richard.
Bucket of chicken.
Bucket of chicken.
Not bad.
That's a good idea.
Very good one. We'll see what's up there. Let's begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Bucket of chicken, you got it right off the bat. Congratulations. Listen, you got $100 more, and that's very good. Now, let's see the $250 response. Bucket of water. Close to your answer, Nipsey, but not quite on it. Now, what do you think is under the big one? They say it's bucket seat, yeah. All right, slide it, please. Bucket seat. You got it. Now, you've won $100, which means the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $1,000. That's assuming you blow the second one completely, which I hope you're not going to do, are you, Jim?
I hope so. I hope not.
No, I hope not. Now, okay. Now, you're going to see right now how much more you'll win with your second audience match. Go. Blank bunnies. All right, let's call them out here.
Richard again.
Playboy Bunny.
Brett.
How about the Easter Bunnies?
Easter Bunny. Suzanne? Oh. Third is a tough position to be in because all the good answers are gone. Yeah.
Think of blondes.
Now think about it. Maybe an answer will fly down from heaven.
Think of blondes. What is a blonde called?
Shh.
A dumb bunny.
A dumb bunny.
What?
And what a kind of... He told you to say that. Really? It's not true. She's very intellectual, smart, and all that. Okay, so there are the three. Dumb bunny, Playboy bunny, and Easter bunny. You may choose one of those, Jim, again, or give us one of your own.
Playboy came to my mind.
Playboy. All right, they want you to go with Playboy. Let's go over here and find out where the Playboy bunny is. May we see the $100 response? Snow bunnies. Snow Bunny is a lady who goes to the ski slopes and has all of the beautiful costume and the great skis and wonderful boots and all that and never goes on the slopes. They call her a Snow Bunny.
Oh, that's what they were saying.
Never gets out of... Well, never mind. May we see the $250 response? Easter Bunnies. Who gave you that? Brett gave you that one.
Playboy.
All right, here's your last chance for the Playboy Bunny. May we see it, please? Yeah! Jim, this time you won $500. We multiply that by 10 makes $5,000. Add it to the previous $1,000 you won, gives you a pot of $6,000 to shoot for here. And we're going to give you that money. But first, you got to match one celebrity exactly.
Richard.
All right. Stand on the blue dot there. Face me. Good luck to you. Get your ESP flowing over to Richard. Come up with the same answer he's come up with. We give you $6,000. Here it is. Sponge blank. That's S-P-O-N-G-E blank. Sponge blank. Sponge blank. Now, he's finished, Jim. You think about it for a second and give us an answer. Try to match him now. There it is. Sponge blank. What do you say to that? Sponge blank.
Boy, I'm drawing a blank.
Now, wait a minute. Think about it for a second. Sponge
blank.
You have to say something.
Off.
Sponge off. Wait a minute, it's something. You never know here. All right, Richard, he says sponge off.
Sponge rubber.
Sponge rubber.
Sponge cake.
Either or.
Yeah. Sponge cake is another good one, isn't it? Yeah. A couple of good ones here. You had a tough one, but you picked up a grand total of $600. Congratulations. Now we got this message just for you. Listen, I hope you're going to join us next time, because many of these beautiful people will be back here again next time. We'll have a lot of laughs. Got a lot more money to give away here on Match Game PM. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive the Armada Touchmatic Radar Range, a footmatic power shift that allows complete control of cooking speeds before or as you cook. Remember, if it doesn't say Armada, it's not a radar range. And High Gain is 2701 for full power 40 channel mobile CD enjoyment. High Gain is global leader in personal communications. And Mr. Coffee, revolutionary 10 to 2 cup coffee saver. Joe DiMaggio says, great coffee taste without coffee waste, plus genuine Mr. Coffee filters. And turn your fireplace into a mini furnace with the Cardinal Firebird heating system. Saves fuel by doubling fireplace heat output. Firebirds and Cardinals. And Prestone antifreeze coolant. Protecting against winter freeze up summer boil overs and rusting corrosion for 50 years. Prestone antifreeze coolant. And Bardol's new fuel system treatment. The gasoline additive to help keep your entire fuel system clean from gas tank to carburetor. You'll feel the difference. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. We'll be right back.